Hi guys. Today I want to talk to you about the highest probability of whining. That's right, you heard that correctly. The highest probability of whining. A lot of people don't understand negative circumstances and they can complain about them, but they don't know what's back of it. You know, you have the analogy of when things go really well, the analogy of the bus, having the right people on the right seat of the bus. Well, that gives you the highest probability of winning. But the highest probability of whining, take the same analogy. You have the wrong people in the wrong seat of the bus, and then you wake up to the fact you're driving the wrong bus. And that will give you a high probability of whining. Well, what goes into that? Well, whining really sets us up for failure. It's all about a mindset. It's a disposition, a negative mindset. Some of those things come from the belief things can never change. So you go from day to day, week to week, month to month, you see the same thing, you believe the same thing, you talk the same thing, and it perpetuates the same thing. And that will give you the high probability of whining because you don't see change because you don't plan for it. That's a scarcity mindset, by the way. And understanding that would help you to begin to change the way you think. There are other people who pay no attention to their self-talk. They don't understand that the thoughts you have indicate where you are at, how you see the world around you. And that's what forms your vocabulary. So your self-talk eventually will become part of your vocabulary. It will find its way into your conversations with other people. The negativity just begins to feed on itself. And that too will give you the highest probability of whining. Well, what do I mean by that? Of always crying that things aren't going right. Nothing ever happens for me. That starts within. So that begins with the self-talk. And the self-talk really stems from the lack of self-awareness. The lower the self-awareness, the higher probability of whining. The higher your self-awareness, the higher probability of winning. And really, that is up to us. So first, we have to change our thinking. And the best way to change your thinking is change what you're listening to and change what you're reading and begin to build yourself up. And also, that will help you with your self-talk. You'll begin to talk to yourself differently. You'll be giving yourself a pep talk every morning. You'll get excited. That will give you more of a probability of winning rather than always repeating the highest probability of whining. And one other thing that gives you the highest probability of whining is being envious of other people's success. And I've seen that through the years, 40, 50 years, I've seen people complaining about other people, saying they're not so hot, they're not this, they're not that. And I find that after a while of listening to them, all the people they're talking about are successful. So basically, they're envious. Why? It's because they have a negative mindset. It's a scarcity mindset. So they always wake up with a high probability of whining because they go to sleep whining and lamenting how bad the day was. So it really is up to you where the probabilities lie. Do you want a high probability of winning like my partner Chad talked about, or do you want a high probability of losing? So that losing is going to make you whine even more, which perpetuates more negative things and more scarcity mindsets and more negative talk. And of course, you'll perpetuate the highest probability of whining. So my hope for you is that 2021, you'll see a higher probability of winning. So be careful of your self-talk, be careful of the things you read, be careful of the people you surround yourself with. Because in 2021, my hope for you is that you will never be in a situation where you'll have a high probability of whining. So I hope that helps you. Until next time, bye.